We got a whole lot of Daves for you right now as we talk tree. I'm here with Dave Madden with Davey Tree to talk about tree cleanup, limb cleanup, tree repair, tree health, all these issues in the wake of the rain and the flooding we've seen, what we thought we might have seen today or yesterday, and what we know still could be around. Just basically the bottom line, Dave, is a lot of people have to do yard work and have to clean things up around their property.
Definitely some cleanup, still cleanup left from Memorial Day, right. And we'll get caught up on that eventually. This storm, luckily, we kind of dodged a bullet on that one, but there were a few trees down, a few limbs down. We did have some wind blowing and we had some rain. But the ground's still wet and the pump is still primed, yeah. So we still have to be proactive.
And Dave, it's so interesting. We were just talking right before we went on about the work you've done in the last few years. It's been all about protecting trees or who might be dangerous because of the drought. Now we've got the exact opposite problem.
Nursing them through the drought was one thing. Now we've got the opposite. Trees with a lot of new growth, heavy branches. They might be weakened still from the drought, but now they're putting on all this weight. So some proactive trimming would be beneficial to thin and lighten up some of the canopies and reduce limb breakage.
Yeah, I guess we talk about debris and obviously people just at the work of cleaning up some limbs that have already fallen. But let's talk a little bit about some of the trees that may be in danger. You said you've been receiving a lot of pictures of trees that have stood through these storms but may be in rough shape. How can you gauge that as you go about your property?
Well, sadly, what we saw on the Blanco River was unprecedented in most people's lifetimes. Trees that maybe had withstood numerous floods and hundreds of years old. Were literally scarified by the force of the rushing water and all the debris that was with that water, literally peeling the bark off the trees. Mm-hmm. And people would send a picture of a tree with green leaves still on it, but absolutely 100% of the bark stripped off. And you'd have to say, well, that tree's dead. It just doesn't know it yet. Once it dries out, it will be gone. But with such ground, soaked ground, you've got to watch for trees that might be showing you signs that something's going wrong. A tree leaning unusually, slightly more than it was before, maybe a rising hump on the soil on the backside of that tree. Any tree you're suspicious of, you should have a certified arborist inspect and look at the hazard potential of that tree.
Kind of like with your own health, look for something that's not normal. Not if you know how your tree should look, both at the base and the roots and so on. If something looks different.
If a tree is reacting differently than it normally has, something has changed. Floods can do a lot of different things. They can remove soil from a tree's root zone and destabilize it. They can add soil and raise the grade, which may be a more latent type of damage that you may not see for a year or two. It could be root rot 5 years later. The tree may suddenly, late in the summer, begin to show its fall color prematurely, and that can be a sign of weakness, and that's unusual and a sign of stress.
So if it's a problem that's 5 years down the road, is there more of a chance to maybe fix that and correct it and save the tree?
If soil has been added or displaced, that should be inspected. If too much soil has piled up onto the tree's critical root zone, you want to remove that soil carefully back down to the natural grade, maybe have it aerated and fertilized to promote healthy new growth, but get those roots back down to grade and not let them smother.
Okay. And Dave, you talked about doing the safety check on the trees on your property. If the news and when you get the arborist out there, if it does look bad and looks like the tree needs to come down, people need to make that tough decision. It's emotional for a lot of people. First of all, it's a financial investment, and some people love their trees, but it can be very dangerous if you leave a tree that's dying on your property.
Absolutely, and you know, get more than one opinion if you need to. Mm-hmm. But you know, those large trees, they've got a lifespan. They don't live forever, and sometimes, sadly, we see some of these old, mature trees end their lives with a bang. Yeah. And that's the bang we don't want to see.
And you at least need to look around your property to see what could be damaged by falling trees or falling limbs. Just kind of take a look around.
Broken limbs are always the obvious thing. You mm-hmm. see broken limbs hanging up in a tree. Well, they need to be cared for. Even if the limb broke and fell all the way to the ground, we hear sometimes people say my tree's self-pruning. Well, that's not pruning. That's breakage. And the wound stubs where the limb broke off even should be cleaned up and properly cut so that the wound can close and not cause a place where decay would enter later in the years.
Okay. Good for the health of the tree and also just good cosmetically as well.
Absolutely.
So some people can give you a call. I know you're very busy right now still and staying busy this time of year anyway. So we appreciate some of your time to talk about tree health and
you
safety.
Bet.
Dave Madden with Davey Tree. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.